Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back. Brandon again. Today, I want to talk to you about the Rogue 26'er wagon wheel, which is just about 26 inches in diameter, hence the name. But let's be honest, from a marketing standpoint, 26'er sounds a lot better than the Rogue 25.895'er. But what do I know? I'm just a guy in a garage. That being said, my next-door neighbor right now decided to electric sand his house during his video. So if you hear any of that extra noise, I'm sorry. This would never happen in the basement. I miss you, my friend. But I want to just give you my first impressions of this. I will eventually do a thorough review more than likely. But what I found for a lot of the stuff that I get that's like new and just released, people just want to know my initial feedback because you're probably wondering if this is something that you should buy or not. Or maybe you've seen it and you want it, but you really aren't sure because you have a couple of questions. That's what I hope to answer in this video. But of course, as always, if I don't answer your specific question, leave it in the comment section below and I'll make sure I get to it. So as I said before, this is a wagon wheel. Rogue has another metal version, which was made in conjunction with Mark Bell and Super Training. It's the second iteration of that. Those look a lot more like wagon wheels than these ones do, but generally speaking, size-wise, this is a bigger wheel or bigger plate than normal. So I think the wagon type name still applies here. What this does from the Rogue side is emulate a 3-inch block pull. So because of the diameter, 26 inches here, it brings the bar up into a higher position, emulating what would be similar to a 3-inch block pull. Now, why would you want to do block pulls in general? Well, obviously, number one, they're a great assistance exercise to your deadlift. They put you in a little bit different of a position. You can work on your lockout a little bit more. For some of us that are taller and pull conventional and just have not the best form overall, hey, that's me. This can also just help you get a lot more work in without stressing your lower back as much. And there's a lot of other uses for it that I'll try to talk about in this particular video as well. Now, why would you want to use this over, let's say, your normal blocks, which, oh, by the way, I have sitting just off to the side of me right here, which I've been collecting dust for a while. For me, a lot of the products that I've been buying these days aren't necessarily innovative in terms of they're brand new and allow you to do something you couldn't have done before. But they take an existing product or an existing idea and improve upon it in terms of convenience, which for me these days is huge because in this case with block pulls, even though I've had my homemade blocks, which didn't cost me that much because I built them from products I got at Home Depot, which by the way, I'll link the video on how to do that if you're interested. I never use them because they're just not convenient to use. Number one, I don't feel like lugging them back and forth. I truly say that even though these plates weigh 70 pounds each, these weigh more than my blocks, but these are easier to move around given the handles and just where they are in regards to my other plates. But more importantly for me, one of the biggest pains on a block pull using it is loading the weights. So if you have a full deadlift jack, that could be a problem because the bar is going to be raised up because it's on blocks. You're not going to be able to reach it and reach the plates. Or even if you have like a mini deadlift jack like I do with the Genesis jack, it still isn't the easiest to change weights as you go and add plate after plate after plate. So what these do is not only lift the bar up off the ground, but as you add normal plates to it, your normal 45s or 35s, because all plates matter, it's a raised surface, so you're never going to have an issue doing it, and it makes loading plates extremely easy. Now, the interesting thing with that whole kind of thought process is when I talked about my bumper plate video and said, you shouldn't buy bumper plates, a lot of you commented in the comment section saying, I like to have a pair of bumper plates on first because the diameter of those are just a little bit bigger than my normal 45 pound plates and it allows me to easily load plates. So this is really taking that idea to the extreme and again, allowing you to do things like block pulls without the actual block. So I think it does serve its purpose. Now, when I take a look at this particular plate, again, when I first posted it, I kind of scratched my head. I thought, is this really necessary? There's already the metal version that are out. And although the metal version has had two iterations by now, I didn't know if there was enough to warrant a new design, especially going from the metal to, let's say, a big old bumper plate. Because I usually associate bumper plates with being a little bit more pricey than your standard metal type plate. It's one of the things I detailed in my picking plate series. Now, when we take a look at the original design from Rogue, one of the biggest complaints about that was number one, with the design, because of the way the spokes were, there are some areas that depending on how heavy of weight you were using and how often you were using it and how hard you were dropping it, the plates themselves could end up flattening out some. So you get some flat spots, which obviously you don't want because if anyone has ever tried to deadlift with like hex plates or the octagon sided plates or however many plate sides they have now, ones that have those straight edges, you know how much of a pain in the ass it can be because the weights tend to settle and rock there. So obviously that's not a good thing when you're talking about these wagon wheels. Another complaint that they got was the fact that with the metal, the lip around it was not only getting flat, but had the tendency to cut into mats, flooring, and damaged floor in that way, which is again something you don't want, especially when you're talking about something that you're loading up with a lot of weight and repeatedly dropping over and over again. So Rogue has come out with a second version of it, which is supposed to improve upon this. I also think part of it was that Titan blatantly copied their original design, so they wanted to have something that differentiated them just a little bit. But I think this plate here is really the next logical progression in that, because again, a bumper plate is meant to be dropped over and over again. Bumper plates for the most part are also typically a little bit thicker, and where that's going to come into play is when you're talking about doing drops of weight with potentially heavy weight. In the past, if you're just having a single plate like the metal wagon wheel, or maybe just a single bumper in place, that might not have necessarily a lot of width to it. So you're going to take a lot of that force into those actual plates and probably going to end up damaging them over time. So the fact that these things right here, the 26ers, are really over-engineered to the point where they're just about 4 inches in width, which according to my friend AM Training Al's is quite a bit of length, although I have seen bigger, is it's going to take a lot more of that force absorption. And add that to the fact that, again, they're bumper plates, they're meant to be dropped. These are going to feel a lot better on your hands and on your joints when you drop it versus dropping metal plates that are connected to a metal bar. So you get a lot more absorption with these in my initial testing of using it so far, which again, I think is a big win in my mind. Now with this too, one of the things you'll find is it has a couple unique design features. Obviously, number one, the diameter of the plate we've already talked about, 26 inches. So it's basically a 3-inch block pull, which is great for block pulls. But that's not the only reason I got it. I'm not going to spend a lot of money on something just because it lets me do one thing very easily. You can also do things like, obviously, pendlay rows with this. So for me, pendlay rows has always been a little bit tough. I've talked about this in previous videos just because of, given my height and the flexion that I can get out of my lower back, it's been a little bit tough because I've always found that I'm in somewhat of a rounded position. So having just those extra 3 inches in this case puts me in a much better position where I can do pendlay rows more effectively. Now in the past, I've had to do them with the straps in my rack, which is okay, or again, with those blocks, which I mentioned, but loading the bar becomes a pain in the ass. So this is going to make things much easier in that regard. Another big thing I'm looking forward to using these on are hip thrusters. So you may have seen, if you follow me on Instagram, I recently picked up Rogue's hip thruster bench, which I'll be doing another video on and sometime in the near future, I'm sure. But one of the other issues I've had with hip thrusters, besides finding a good bench to set up on with, is the fact that for me and my legs and the size of my feet, rolling that bar up over my junk has never been easy. So much so than the fact where it becomes very uncomfortable, even when using a pad. Yes, I do use those pads for hip thrusters. But also being able to get my feet back in the right position. I couldn't do that because the bar was too low and basically crushing my hips. So what these do is actually allow me to easily get under the bar, get into a good position. So much so, in fact, in setting up, I've never been used to being able to get my feet that far back and still yet be in a good position to still do hip thrusters. In fact, if you follow Brett Contreras, the glute guy who literally makes his living off of your ass, he's come out with something called the hip thruster weight plate, which is basically a very similar design to this, being a bigger bumper plate, except it's not as big in diameter. So I think his is 23 inches, which would emulate a 1.5-inch block. And also it weighs 45 pounds versus 70. So speaking of that, one of the unique design features of this is the fact it weighs 70 pounds. All the other wagon wheels I'm familiar with weigh 45, which I think I get where they were going with that. They wanted to make a plate that basically was your normal plate, just kind of stretch it out to make it bigger. But again, when you're talking about dropping this repeatedly time after time with heavier weights, I'd actually think a bigger, beefier plate would be more ideal because it's going to take that brunt impact a lot better. So I think that design cue is also really nice here with it. With this also, what you also get are some handles. You can maybe see some here. I'll show some secondary clips. The handles are offset. And I think initially when I opened this, I was like, that's weird. They should have had it, you know, on the same side on both. That way it'd make like a really good grip handle. Although it does have a slight lip around the edge, which is nice. You can get your fingers in there some. I take back what I said about the handles being lined up. And I say that because, again, when you take a look at this straight on, the width of this normally is 4 inches. Where the actual handles are, even on one side now, that cuts you down basically in half. If you had handles on both, you'd have very little area in order to take that impact, which chances are, again, if you're dropping it time after time after time, you're going to start hitting those spots with not as much coverage area, and that could probably shorten the life of the plate itself. So I see why they did that, and these things are very easy to pick up and move around despite weighing 75 pounds. Also, nice thing with this, they have a metal hub in the middle. The tolerance on this hole, which is something I've talked about in other plate videos, is the tolerance of, number one, the center hole. In this case, you're like at 50.6 millimeters. A bar is 50 millimeters. That means you're not going to get a lot of slack or movement or slop in the barbell. So you're not going to get a lot of that noise or pull, which is going to make for a better fit and also make sure the plates stay in place. The tolerance on the plate itself is still 2%, which is something you typically see in machined plates, which, again, check out those plate videos if you haven't seen them. There's a whole playlist on them. Now, with the 2%, while that's good, as you get into bigger and bigger weights, it becomes a little bit more prevalent about how much weight could potentially be different. Because if you're talking about a 45-pound plate and a 2% difference, that's less than a pound. But when you're talking about a 70-pound plate and a 2% difference, that could be up to almost 1.5 pounds on either side, plus or minus. So that's one of the things. But like I said, when you're dealing with this and you're dealing with deadlifting, as long as you have other plates that are fairly accurate, it shouldn't be that impactful overall, especially given the fact that you're only going to have a single pair of these on the bar itself. So in total, let's say both of these plates were under 2%. So they're both 2% less than what they should be. That ends up being 3 pounds overall. If you're deadlifting 600 pounds, that's not going to be a tremendous difference. One of the things I also want to talk about this, talking about differences, is the pricing. So in addition to this being a radically different design, I mentioned already, one of the things that had me scratching my head thinking of this was initially necessary was the fact that bumper plates are usually a lot more expensive than what you find for other metal plates. Now, I mentioned the metal plate issues already being 45 pounds, having a thin lip, flattening out, potentially doing damage to the mats themselves. With this, when I looked at the price, I almost had to do a double take. In fact, I had to go and look to make sure that it wasn't price per plate, because these are priced right around $265 for the pair. Now, that might seem like a lot of money for you, and to be honest, it is. But again, for the convenience factor of me, and if it makes and means sure that I'm going to be doing hip thrusters more often, I'm going to be doing block pulls more often, I'm going to do pendlay rows more often, it pays for itself time and time again. But the interesting thing for me was when you compare this to the original wagon wheels, which I feel are probably worse than this in terms of the effectiveness, the wagon wheels retail for $425. Now, what gets even more interesting is when you start talking about shipping prices. So again, for a pair of these, $265, it weighs 140 pounds because they're 70 pounds each. For a pair of wagon wheels, the base price is $425. It weighs 90 pounds. Because they're 45 pounds each, but the wagon wheels actually ship together in one single box and they ship light freight. These ship individually and they ship just regular UPS. So when you add in the shipping cost, these things cost me $350 versus if I went with the wagon wheels, which again, in my opinion, are inferior to this design, it would cost me $610. Let that sink in. So you might have thought that price $265 for these is expensive. It is. But it's not $610 expensive. So these, to me, adding up for what they will do, how they're built, they'll allow me to actually do lifts and exercises that I probably wouldn't have done otherwise because of the inconvenience of doing them. And finally, the price savings over what else is available out there. To me, it was a no-brainer to get these in. And even though I've only owned them a day, I'm really excited to own them and I'm looking forward to them, as opposed to something like when I bought a reverse hyper and as soon as I set it up, I was like, this was the biggest mistake of my life. I really am looking forward to doing some of these things like block pulls and hip thrusters and pendlay rows, which I can't say has been true for a very long time. So with that, if you have any other questions that I wasn't able to answer, you guys will see these in my training videos, obviously, and I'll give you more feedback as I get it. But leave your questions in the comment section below. And in the meantime, as always, thanks for watching and stay big.